How's it going?
You guys leaving?
No, I'm just going to my stuff. Yeah, I think so, of course.
All right, so broadcasting live.
You'll move that in. Plug it in.
Back on.
So, they're going to present documents. They're going to be back to you. I'm going to be back to you. I'm going to be back to you.
Thank you for being here today.
You guys missing anything?
Hi, my name is Vinny Rano.
I'm
with the online marketing team.
And my name is Matthew McCormick, and I'm part of the web design.
Now, just to give you a little background information on my engagement model setup, we started out and he saw some faulty painting. You can see that customers would pay for two codes, but the services that they were having only required one code. And this was ripping him off, and he didn't really like that. So he started engaging painting in 2007.
Our team was asked to create a landing page, a website, and several social media accounts to help advertise these messages.
Now, you may be wondering, how are we contacting each other? Because we have different classes, right? Basecamp is a respiratory type of website where we can contact each other and collaborate with each other. For example, we can either talk to our team or talk to our clients, with message boards, to viewers, and much, much more. Now, our landing page for Adrian, you don't know what a landing page is. It's a simple way to tease the customer into bringing them to the full website. For example, we thought that we have the Big Mac or any other thing you'd like to present. That will lead it to the website. Adrian's being the best painting in Central Valley. First thing you see is this big, beautiful picture, very big, so it catches the customer's eye. First thing they see is that picture. We chose a black and white header and footer design with white background and gray button, making it more modernized, professional, and very sleek. Font is the same way. It gives a professional and modernized look along with the button, Call Today. Now the social media, we're heading on to the website.
This is a Facebook page that we created for Adrian. At the top, you can see the cover photo and the profile picture. We chose this for the cover photo because it shows one of his services, interior, painting, and design. And in the profile picture, you can see it's a final product of a client's house. Scroll down. But here in the corner, there is just a box of information, his phone number, his address, where he can be located on the maps. And here is one of our bigger posts that we put. Adrian's painting is here to save the day and help you make your house your masterpiece. It really just explains his the customer service and work efficiency, and it represents how any type of customer wants to be it.
So right here, this is the website that I designed. So right now we're on the home page. Now on the top of this page right here, you can see his logo is right here. It's in very big font just to show, just to capture the customer's eye. And as we go over the navigation bar, which is the words, there's a little hover element. It's just to show very customer appeal. It's very visually appealing. And the font that we chose here, the color scheme, black, white, and gray, font, just to show a very modern and sleek feel. As you scroll down, there's this box right here, and in this box there are two segments. Here's his call to action segment, and then his introductory description. Now you can hover over here, so again, we get that visual feel. And in this first box right here, the services, just prompting the customer to go to services. And also the second box is his appointments. We'll bring you to the contact page and the services box will bring you to the services page. Now on the right of this first box right here, is this introductory description, just to show, to give the customer how much experience he has under his belt, and just to say that he offers very high quality services. Now if you scroll down, there's this testimonial box where it shows all the feedback that he's gotten from many reliable sources. Right here, this is just showing the customer that this company is very trustworthy and backed up by, again, reliable sources. And this right here on the bottom of the page is the footer. It will be displayed on every single page. This is just really to go backtrack to every single part of the page. It's just a really small way of making the navigation. Now, if we go up to the next page, this is about us page. Right here, it just shows a description of the backstory of this company and himself. Not the top right here, obviously, he's not him, but the slide that I chose is very corresponding to each of the pictures, left to right and then right to left. Right to left. And then this first part right here is a description of Adrian himself, a little backstory, personal, how much the experience he has by paying house. Now, the second part right here is a more in-depth description of his company, basically saying where he started, how he started, and how he came to be currently. Now, on the next page, is his services. As you can read up there, we offer a high-quality cleaning services for your house. There's a little subtitle saying, give us a call and set an appointment at his phone number. And if you click the phone number, it will bring you to his contact. So the layout that I chose for this is kind of a catalog view. This shows that you scroll down, you can see the services, the company with a photo. This is showing an example of what that service does. Yeah, exactly, we don't have the corresponding photo, but we will have them in the future. Now, if you scroll down more, and the customer chooses what service he or she wants, they'll click on the Set Appointment tab, and it will bring you to the contact page. Now, this contact page is very simple. This layout is very simple. It just has all the contact information on the left, and an interactive map, too, on the right. So as you can see, his address, phone number, email is on there, and also a prompt telling the customer to call or write up an appointment. And this interactive map just to show where his company will be exactly. Now, of course, it's the company address, but we'll have his address in the future. And that's Adrian's website.
We have learned so much at the beginning of the year working on Adrian's community. Big project in general, opening up my eyes to social media, web development, online marketing, such a big load of things, and it's something that business or business really needs, and I feel like it's been such an eye-opening experience, and I'll never forget.
And also what I learned from this project was really fun working with my team. What I learned from this, it was a really big learning experience. I learned that you really need communication with your team members and also the client to get any project like this done. Technical difficulty trying to contact our client. We still pulled through and made up what we think in his mind what his website would be.
What I
find
from this project is really good communication skills and a lot of professionalism and advisors. So you're going to have your own session with your client right after this, so you can get feedback from the judges, but you guys are going to have your own private session together.
Fantastic. Well, first of all, well done. Your voice clarity, your presence and voice is very well. Congratulations. There you go. So great. First question, you talked about communication, you've learned a lot about it. So what do you need some details of like what you learned?
All of communicating with the clients and knows the what he wants.
Can you tell me like how you push up, how you figure out? Communicating with the client, we got to know him more as a person, so we put these photos in there. Or maybe his response or his information or his layout, whatever we wanted, just to really thought that would be him. And we were also looking for the future more in the field because of the company, starting where he started with the one. We were just going for that. We needed more phone time, more email, more text. What worked best was we talked to him, and I think though we got more information him just sending us information about his company, us asking questions about his company, and then him sending us the required information.
So you guys used Basecamp. Was that mainly for communication between your team, or did that include that as well?
It included us as a team thinking of things to talk to the client and messages to send it. And then we send a message to the client to communicate to him.
I think the website is great. It's definitely an exercise that I was doing while I was in my school.
Yeah.
kind of guys practice. Something really well, and I didn't feel the first one that I could use based on personal story. So, it was the guy after, that's the project. And, yeah.
Thank you.
Actually, I'm scared of the phone.
Oh, wow, nice.
That's the broadcast when you guys are over here. You guys have a computer? Yeah, bring one in.
We were told that, but you said it's already in front of you.
Well, we were told you was on.
Get 112, or 12.
I
feedback.
Ryan Matthew.
I'm a sponsor.
Yeah,
I'm Lillian Simmons, and we are the three interns for internshiping for a company called Green Rose Productions. Okay, so Green Rose Productions is a company that is founded by Rosalind Liberty. Rosalind Liberty owns one other company in Visalia called Visalia Opera. Green Rose Productions is a company that Rosalinda wanted to branch off from our Visalia Opera House to create a name for herself in Visalia. She wanted it to be something different from the Opera House, where she wasn't just the backstage writing the scripts and at the rehearsal. She wanted it to be something where her face would be known in Visalia for her Selena tributes, her mariachi shows, and her show that Crawdaddy. The way that both of our teams, our online marketing team and our web design team, created her landing page and her website was through Cloud9. Cloud9 is a website where that is linked to GitHub, where you can put in CSS code and to create content for the site and go and create styling in the CSS to create things like color, margins, tying that really shapes the look of the website. Now, so this is what we use for our landing page that our online marketer Matthew created.
Okay, so for the header, we take out the color from the logo, and from the logo, we decide to go the header. And for the name one, I put a piece of white to build it, and we have a video to let the users know what she put on and what she left out. And you see a video of this, and then I put an extra cover on the left hand side, and we have also a description of how long she's been singing, how long she's been dating, and kind of a personal work. And the link to call to action. Just come watch the video. And I put a shout here. The kind of for like a new design. And the rest of it, like, it goes down. And I was on the contact information and computer. And the button leads to it.
So when you click on the button, it will take you to her main website. The landing page is just used as a way to get viewers to come to her website and to entice them to look further into what Green Rose Production is really about. So we designed our landing page and our website to look very similar, so the user would know the familiarity of them both. And at the top, we have our header. Black line to split the pages so people know the difference between the navigation and the other sections that are in our page. And then we have our video to entice people to watch it. And that's what it did. And below that, we have another line separating sections. For Rosalinda shows, we use a red font color, and we use a font that was very similar to her logo font. We added many pictures, six pictures of different shows that she has, to give an example, again, of what she does. And then below that, we have our footer with the hover on the navigation that transitions from the lighter shade of green to the dark shade of green, and again, the black font to the white font. And then if you go to our About page.
For About page, you can say that there is a single page. This section, under it, you have a headshot, the photo is under, the face is the image of the font. And for this section, you have a little portion of what she does.
Again, at the top of the page, we use a black line to separate all of the sections, and we use a font that is similar to her logo for the headings, and we use a simpler font that is more legible and easy to read because it is a bigger paragraph. And then below that, we have another line separating the videos, and separate our videos, and on our contact page, you wanted to keep it simple. We just put all of her personal contact information and a location of where her office is on this map that is interactive. And you can move the map around and zoom in and zoom out. Underneath, we wanted to include her Crawdaddy's location because Rosalinda, she performed there every week and thought it was something that was stable and consistent and that her customers and clients would want to come out and see. And again, we have another map that you can move around and zoom in and zoom out on. And in our Twitter, we on the social media apps, they also have a cover over them. And if you click on them, they take you to the social media pages that our online marketing team has created and has to show you.
So for the Facebook, I chose to use the logo, the flower from her logo, to use for her profile picture, then a group photo after a very good performance that had a lot of attention of her and some of her fellow gang members. And if you scroll down, you'll see some of the previous posts that I have posted. I posted about today's event from her and the work that we will be showcasing for her. If you continue to scroll down, you will also see some posts about videos that she has previously made. And this one is an informative picture of when she performs, what time, and who she performs with. It's also under the Crawdaddy's name. And we also chose the same thing for the caption of the picture. This was one of the first posts that we posted to help people hear about her and her company. So we chose to use this video because this was one of her very beginning videos that she started with from Crawdaddy's, and this was her first time performing with this specific band. She used to just perform by herself. So we thought this would be a good video to use for her very first post on her Facebook. If you go to Twitter, we use very similar posts. We just shorten them down using the fact that we only have a certain number of characters and faces to use. I chose the same logo for her profile picture, but the cover photo was a mashup of multiple pictures that she sent us that are web designer being created. And it had perfect spacing for the profile pictures and other her pictures are long. We used multiple ones from different performances, from where she was performing by herself, where she was showing by herself, headshots in different events that she performed at. If you scroll down, we also put other posts about different things she's doing, where to see her, inviting, there's a call to action, inviting people to come and see her, like come and dance with her, look at her, visit her here. This was also another first post, but we decided to start this one off with today's event. Just meaning that we were showcasing all of her work and wanted to make sure that her company was getting a lot of attention. From the marketing side of this project, we feel like we've had very big things with our team. We did have some communication issues as far as the team being in two separate classrooms, but we were able to overcome that and create our landing page and our website.
So this is the site that we use called Basecamp to communicate. Just in my personal opinion, from this experience, I feel like it was harder for me to navigate through Basecamp, and there was a communication issue throughout our project. Just the fact of being in different rooms and not really being educated on how to navigate through this site easily, and I think it affected our end product in some ways. But definitely, when we got to be in the same room together, we collaborated and we pulled through, and I'm very proud of what have accomplished with our groups. We've come a long way throughout this experience.
We also know that the work with our clients that we did on Basecamp was a little rocky in the beginning because we didn't teach her how to use it. But after meeting with her and showing her on Basecamp and teaching her how to use it, she interacted with us very well on the message board and from talking to the client. She communicated with us and got to us some very big pictures. She sent us a lot of pictures after learning how to do them, and we were able to use those pictures in her website and her landing page and with her social media. We also informed her about everything going on, like today's event, meetings we're doing, our progress with her stuff. We communicated with her very well and kept our vocabulary very professional.
Do you guys have any questions for us?
So, all in all, it looks really good. It looks like you have done a great job at kind of doing and rewiring the entire suite. It's really kind of cohesive blood presence for her. So you had mentioned in talking a little bit about communication. Other than that, if you go back and change anything, right?
I think that something that, since we are a first year school, that it's not, we're just figuring everything out, the teachers and everything, but I think next year, if students were to do this, I think it would be great to teach the classes separately in the beginning of the year. And instead of every day going and working separately in your two different classes and communicating through Basecamp, I think it would be nice if every other day or more frequently we came together and worked in the same environment doing our separate jobs. Because it was hard when we were trying to work on learning how to build a website and we were building our website and we needed quick feedback from our other team about design changes, anything like that. And it was harder for us to write a message when in class and send it to them and wait for them to reply, because by that time class was already over and we were already moving on to our next subject. And so I think it would be better if we were in the same room, and I think that our end product would have been to a whole other level.
So more in-person collaboration.
In-person collaboration. Okay.
We feel that other than communication, we could have done better with our decision making. We kind of took a while to do it because we were very skeptical on whether our client would like it or not, or whether our website would agree with it. So we did feel like we could have made that decision.
When you made that decision, did you have this person
like that? Yeah, we have very flexible schedules with each other. We're very flexible with the work we were doing. Nothing was coming, we were always able to change it. Our client was also very understanding, and she was very patient with us, so she understood any problems that we had, and she worked with us.
Well, I'll say, you were very thorough. You made eye contact with me, and your voice was very good. Did I like the person definitely the content on social media? Logo use, you great there, picture and video, and matchup. And the whole
you guys included everything I would expect to see for that much.
A couple of you talked about the issue of change, but we got kind of talked about what was the question. What was the question? What was the question? What was the question? What was the question?
I think it was hard for especially me to be meeting after school, because I was trying to do a business project. I think my schedule was overloaded, and I definitely wish that I put more time and effort personally into this project after school. I definitely think that would have been a really, really good idea. More personal.
Definitely take that with you with the next person you're going to go. Yeah, first, today's presentation, you're right. One question I had is, what is Rodo on this like, main objective besides bookings for an interview or two of them? I guess I was still trying to figure out what would be the objective besides
her. I feel like the main objective besides for her was just having a place. I think that her company is brand new. Her company was made literally months before she brought it to us. It's a brand new company, it's just a baby. So I think that she just wanted something where it was about her personality, and about the way she performs, instead of just about the opera house, because she's so stuck with the opera and only being able to do opera. I think she wanted it to be a personal site that was kind of brand new. And that people wouldn't just see it as a company, but see it as Rosalinda's entertainment.
Rosalinda wanted to embrace her Hispanic culture, and she can't really do that when we're opera company. So with this company, she decided to take it off by doing mariachi performances, Selena's tributes. She had plans for other big shows for her company, but she wanted to make sure that she had the attention and the money to do it. But she wanted to break off from her opera company and expand before she could really put on any shows, because she knows she is available for booking reservations, weddings, she's
we just didn't get to implement that onto our site because it wasn't for sure, and it was always maybe, and I didn't want to put it onto our site if it was going to make her unhappy. I wanted to stick to the things that she told us that she definitely wanted and invest our time in those places. But again, we were kind of short on time given the class. Any questions? Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
We got to move it so that it's pure from it.
No, it's complete the setup.
You just have to move it so.
Are you using your laptop? So. Okay, I'm gonna wait for a little.
Yes.
Good afternoon. I'm Zachary.
I'm Imani.
I'm Phelan.
And we are the online marketing team.
My name is Owen.
My name is Jeanette.
And we are the web developer.
And we are Simply Joy. Our client, Joy Bang, lived in Minnesota before becoming president. There, she started her own company, Bang Photography. The company where she kept her work finding the channel with the customers, to make it easier upon herself and the customers to capture those perfect moments. But now Joy Bang's a president, and she has given us the task of completely rebranding the company. But to keep her mission the same, to capture beautiful moments and share it with the world through Simply Joy.
Is the best photographer for your wedding. Here at Simply Joy, we focus on two things, capturing intimate and unique photos from your special day and turning them into a lifelong memory for anyone to enjoy. Capture your moments now. In our online marketing classes, we are learning how to create landing pages and make them unique for our clients. We were able to look through a website called Deposit Photos, where we had the access to a variety of stock photos, and we got to choose the best one that we thought best fits with the joy, which is how we got our background for our lens. Learning about in our online marketing classes is typography. And how typography can invoke a certain emotion through a lens. If you go to my CSS in my room, you can see here I have the hand weave of font family chosen and the Concordia font family colored out. Now if I were to switch these two,
and go back to my landing page, you can see the difference between the two fonts. Here, the Conforta is more bold and it's bigger and more bulkier, whereas the Hanley is more simple and handwritten and it's easier to read. Another thing that we've been able to do in our team together as a team was ideate colors and create this logo. Although communication with our client was poor, we were still able to use burgundy and gray colors that are consistent throughout our landing page and our website. These colors represent compassion and intimacy.
This is the homepage for the website that we need for the Simply Joy. As you can see here, we have a very clean and simple layout, which is very flexible to change if we have the communication that we provide in the description. At the top, we have a navigation with an active tab. So whichever tab is actually ordered around, that's which page they're on. So that gives it makes it intuitive for the user to be able to navigate through the pages. Underneath that, we have a gallery that can go left and right. You can click either of the two arrows, and if you do not click the arrows, it'll automatically scroll over a period of 1.5 seconds. Underneath there, we have a testimonial section with a picture of someone from her Twitter account. We're not actually sure if that is really big or not, so we just wanted to make sure we had a picture of someone that was professional. And then next to that, we have a testimonial section, which we kind of made what clients would or may have said, since we only have the communication. And then on the bottom, we have a footer with different links to social media, and then in the center, a navigation so that you don't have to scroll all the way back to the top when you're navigating.
So, as you see here, it'll be 3 seconds. Navigation, header, and footer. Here the navigation is, you can see it's from the home page as well as throughout the other things. What is different for now is ordered around the left page, notifying you which page you're on and what's your debug. Here is Joy Bang, here's a big title telling you who Joy Bang is and what she wants to provide for you. You might ask why is it different spelled from her company? It's because she wanted to add more feel to her company name than just look. Down here we have 2 paragraphs explaining a little bit of background, how she became a photographer and what she can provide for you, and as well as communicating very well. Here on the right side is a self-portrait of what will be Joy Bang. So you can have a visual and recognize how Joy Bang looks like for whenever you see her. On the bottom, there's the same footer, so you can have access to her social medias, as well as more navigation if you do not feel like going back up. And now we're going to go to the gallery.
Here on the galleries tab, we created a gallery for all of Joy Bang's photos to get an insight on her work. And we decided to go with a very simplistic and modern design. In our development for our gallery, we came into a bit of complications because we did a pattern that turned out to be very displeasing and distracting, so we decided to go with the design just here. Currently, we do not have any Joy Bang's work yet, but we have the filler response photos. So we'll use the paper photos and go into the conversation. Here on the concept page, we created a very intuitive and simple design. This displays all of her information, such as phone number, address, and location. We also created a form for scheduling meetings, any questions or concerns.
Facebook is a very important tool to promote engagement. It can be kept to. So although it's useful to call it, then draw in the customer to your website or actually buy the product.
got something going. We use Facebook to show our company business. That is that we have some good connections with our customers, and that we can deliver good products with the high quality photos that have been those beautiful moments. And you see, oh, and we do so by but the main deal is calling to action to our website, giving part of the website, so they actually buy our product.
pushing code 5.16, and when she goes to GitHub, it should also say pushing code 5.16.
Right here, pushing goes by the OCC. You should only change the event spot.
And that's it for the time.
You may be asking, how do we get our content if we're divided into two classes, the online marketing, which is upstairs, and web development, which is downstairs? Well, the solution was our instructors introduced us to a reliable tool called Basecamp. Basically, what Basecamp is where we go as a team, even our instructors and our clients are included in this so they can add in on the information they want for their website. How do we make these messages? Well, we can talk about it on Campfire, which is basically a group conversation where everyone is knows what we're talking about. Say, oh, should we do more pictures on this side or should we put more content on there? And we just make these changes. A message board is also notified us by email. You can see it on your devices or on your phone. We make this document, which we uploaded here, so you can look at it and you can access to your website. And that's very important because the clients themselves can also add pictures they want for their website. Here on the to-dos is what we need to have by a certain date. So we can have time management and we won't be confused where we're going. So basically all this game that the Basecamp does is help us have more time management and we won't be stressed out by, oh, did we have this? Did we have that? And it's just a great website to use if you're making a team, a business for your client.
Through the work we've done for Simply Joy, we have gained valuable skills. We have learned HTML, CSS, program our own websites and landing pages. We have learned about typography and color swatches to help evoke emotion into our target audience. We have learned how to run and continually run a campaign on different social medias. We have learned how to use Photoshop and Illustrator to help optimize photos to our clients' needs. We plan to use it for our business in the future so we can reshape the future. But what have we truly created? We have created tools, essential tools, to help promote and prolong the company. But more importantly, we have created essential tools to not just accomplish the company's goal, but someone's vision in life. In this case, Joy Bang's vision, capturing beautiful moments and sharing it to the world.
Thank you for your time. Is that dropping my hand?
Start out so strong, really motioned, you closed, you kept the energy up the whole time. You drew me in and I stayed with you until they closed me. Well done.
Absolutely well done. I know how challenging it can be to work with clients that just does not want to do the same product. As a developer, I love getting a little glimpse into the code and a little GitHub monitor. That really helped me. I gotta say, everything looks like Facebook looking for me to find. Everything is exactly what I would expect to see with kind of doing website. You've got the gallery, info about the product, but overall it is a beautiful website.
That was extraordinary, guys. If you all are not in the top three, I'm not gonna vote. So I'll let you know too that so Andrew on the end here is one of the exciting startups and credit on the Derek is probably one of the top five developers in our city. And if you want to get what you need to go to the DC stuff, that's Derek's work. These guys are the real dealers in the press them. I'm sure you who did what? So what were each of the roles?
Wait, who are you?
Well, we kind of broke down a couple of roles. We had a project manager, we had a photographer. photographer and designer. We had a co-project manager because we had to make sure we get on the track. We have a lead developer and we had a co-developer. And I basically worked with a lot of the posts we did. We all had to make individual posts. What was the brainstorming?
Zach, let's just be real. You're just the pitch person.
And the pitch person. And we basically just took on one task at a time and we went on Basecamp. Yeah.
No, you're fine. No, you guys did it.
But honestly, most of the website was Owen and Matthew. They created the design and we just added color and words. For the most part, they're the ones who made the editing design. Imani and Tayana were the ones who made me work on the landing page. Imani especially, where her photo aesthetically pleasing picture she chose. She worked through Photoshop as a master. And me and Yvette were basically kicking up whatever we lacked in and just trying to catch up and make sure we're ahead of game.
There's some sort of things that you did that were really impressive. We're pretty easy by having actually doing the work in front of us twice. You did that for the bond as well. That was really nice. And bringing the audience in is something that trade that is not always seen in terms of the lecture. So, well done, Matt. You know, from all the people on the pictures, it was really slight using the black and photos to do the on the website. You could have picked green and orange and black, but it just kept it nice and simple. So the detail there is really nice too. You guys seem like a perfect are you?
We have.
why do you think it worked out so well?
Honestly, because we were going to get it. We all had our hopes slightly, part of the hopes of danger. We put out our heart in and we don't have to be talking about programming, doing and working and make sure that students get it. So it's only because we all dedicate the time.
Sure. And that's what I wish for everyone who just have it, so we start to come
in.
Oh, they're amazing.
right?
I mean, the pitch that kept it, yeah, it was fantastic.
Owen was amazing. Owen, the early hair long.
Yeah.
He's awesome. There's a lot of strong people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
I can
look
at that.
Thank you.